can smell the smoke lingering, this, the incense of the smoke. And I thought about it, and then I thought about all the fires, the wildfires that they're having in California right now. And this poem's called Fire, Destroyer and Creator. While 20 wildfires rage in California, I smell soothing smoke scent from an old fireplace in Tennessee. The beauty of fire's containment, to cook a community meal, warm a cave, deter wild bobcats, smith metals. But in which way does human comfort match a forest flaming uncontrolled? Igniting quail's nests and cedar chests, singeing coyote holes and victims' clothes, leveling homelands of plant, animal, and homo sapien denizens, at best leaving them homeless citizens. Perhaps that's why Zeus withheld the violence of fire from mortals, while Prometheus nonetheless stole it back to roast winter meals of lamb shanks and warm the nursery where his titan son lay. A scientist may ask, what is fire and where does it go? Only part of what combusts is visible, which both destroys and creates our material world. While a poet inquires, does the invisible remains hold torch in fervent hearts, or in the mind's ideas that catch like fire, sent up like daily offerings of incense as we burn through the years of our desires? Wow.